Hi, this is my project title Cook Buddy using AI image recognition. Cook Buddy, which is a cooking companion, it will come wherever we go in a form of an app. The app is like a sous chef. So what the app does is it can recognize the food items and it will tell you that this food item is name is this, and it will show you the particular recipe according to that. But in the old days, what the people are doing is to feed a machine to tell a name of a particular item is by using the features like color, shape, and texture. But when it comes to the food, we can't actually tell that the food items will look like this. So a basic example for that is if you are eating bread and butter from a restaurant called Air, and the butter and the food will butter and the bread will look slightly different when we are comparing that same food that we are going to eat in our home. So the presentation and the way that they are making that item, which will change the texture and the color of that particular food images. So the image classification and recognition is a challenging issue, like food items to recognize it and classify them and also tell you the recipe according to that. So what I'm doing is I'm using an artificial intelligence computer vision technique to identify a food item and tell you the recipes according to that particular item. So these are my objectives: to make an efficient cooking app, to enable the computer vision like the smallest storage devices like smartphones, to detect the food items simultaneously and classify them using smartphone. So the image classification and the recognition has been a well-known and challenging issue for decades. It was applied to several domains for different purposes, such as health, transportation, robotics, and food processing. There are vast techniques to classify and recognize image, and one of the most famous among them is to extract images, features including color, shapes, textures, and then feed them into a machine learning algorithm. Nevertheless, the top challenge is how to select an appropriate features for the target image, especially when the images are in complex terrain structures. Food images are the example of complex images. For classification and recognition, they are usually composed of different proportions with the different size, textures, and colors. Recently, the food images become a major interesting issue in the complex computer vision according to the several factors. The factor number one is the people, especially aging population and patients, pay more attention to the healthy food. And the fact number two is simplicity of using smartphone's camera and let us take photos of food and share them easily, which facilitates the accessibility and the creation of a food data set. And the fact number three is an advancement of machine learning research, and is probably rent the possibility of adapt and apply machine learning algorithm to deal with the complex images on a less processing power equipment such as a smartphone. So these are the literature survey that I done. So we will tell that the older days, the people are taking the shape based features and the color and shapes and deep learning algorithm. But by using these kind of things, we can't actually tell that a food item will look like this and the food item color is like that, because when we are traveling from one state to another state, also the food item's color and the way of presentation may change. Not only that, we can just simply see from the restaurant to restaurant. When we are going from a restaurant, we can see that the food color and texture and the way of the presentation, which will be different from our home. So by using the shape-based features and colors, shape, and size textures, and it is not going to be a common way for recognizing some of the food. So some papers, which is published in 2016, in IEEE conference, which used the using the transfer learning tag of factorization model using different type of features with conventional neural network, provide the best result. So by referring this paper, I come to an end that I can make a model
through the machine learning and with the help of a computer vision to recognize food images. So the existing system are mainly like they are trying to capture the global appearance of the food. Existing system are also based on voice and text searches. Existing food recognition system are based on visual representation. The voice and the text searches, which is if you are telling a food name or the something like that on a particular app, there is a lot of apps are out there. So it will give you the recipe of that particular item that we are saying or we are typing on there. So these kind of apps doesn't have that special features to recognize a food item and tell you that this food item is this, and this food item can cook like this also, something like that. So these kind of things are missing on the existing system. So disadvantages of the current system is food items are highly deformable. So many recognition systems are based on feature extraction. So as I tell earlier, the food item, we can't classify food item based on the shapes. So we can easily classify the items on like a bowl or like something. But in the case of bowl also, if you teach the system that the bowl will look bowl will be in a round shape and it will be bumpy and it will be orange color, something like that, and we feed into the system. And the next time when the system will recognize a rounded shape subject, like which will be maybe an orange or an apple, something like that. So the system will recognize it as a bowl. So all the time we need to reshape it, and we need to tell the system that the orange, this is an orange and this is a bowl, something like that. So these kind of things are a harder thing to extract the features and tell you the to feed the system. They can detect only a single object to which they are narrowed. As I tell earlier, it can't tell you a difference between a bowl and an orange. Inter-class variation easier, but intra-class variation detection process is complex.
It can understand why one item, but it cannot understand a different kind of items, because the shape may vary. The simple example for that is an apple, orange, and a bowl. The three items will be mostly look like a rounded shape. But we cannot say that this is the orange have something like extra, like it is a bumpy or like something like that, because the ball also look bumpy in sometimes. For lesser storage platform for recognizing the system can't be implemented. Lesser storage system like a smartphone. So we currently we are using the computer vision on the machine learning techniques in many system, like for operation on a hospital or like something. In many cases we are using the artificial intelligence, but we cannot, but still we can't actually use a proper system on a mobile devices. So this is also a challenging thing for us to make an artificial intelligence algorithm to work with them on a lesser storage devices like a smartphone, basically an Android phone, something like that. So the problem that we are identified, which is in contrast to object, food items are highly deformable, which means it doesn't have any shapes or shape size or like something. Not suitable for lower storage system. Currently, there is no particular way that we can say that this can recognize food items, or we can implement a system on a lesser phone. Lesser storage devices, then high intra-class variability. So which means that different cooking style and seasoning will lead to different appearance of a same food. Like I said earlier, from one restaurant to another restaurant, the food items may vary, like the presentation, the way of presentation, and the way of cooking that they are doing. It can vary. So then no optimization, which means the model cannot be optimized and use it on a smaller storage devices like smartphones. So the proposed system, which have the we are developing the system, uses the deep learning based conventional neural network for training. Then uses some open edge classifier for smaller storage systems. For like example, I told you earlier, Android is mobile. Performance good with intra class similarity, highly optimizable. So the proposed system is mainly based on the Google's TensorFlow, which is a machine learning library, which already have some extra capabilities of learning some complex set of data. So I'm using a classifier which is called a MobileNet, which is also a Google's classifier. So I'm training the data through that MobileNet classifier optimizing that model to use it on an Android devices. So the hardware software requirements are like this. So for building a model, we need a i5 or above processors and a RAM of 12 GB and RS of 500 GB and monitor. You can use any type of monitors. Input devices like keyboard and mouse. For Android application, IPA level 25 and above, which means it will support after 6.0. And the camera version is 5 MP, and the device RAM at least you have 2 GB RAM, because nowadays the most of the phone packed with the 2 GB RAM. And the software environment, which is for a front end, is Java, Android. The interpreter language is Python. The operating system is Windows 10, and the mobile OS is Android above 6.0, which is above the Marshmallow, can support all the kind of things. So this is the architecture design of the current system that we are going to propose, which is called the CookBuddy. And I will explain you from the implementation flowchart, which will be easily to understandable. So it's like image data set. So we are collecting the images from the Google. We are currently collecting the images from the Google, from particular Indian food items, and we are feeding that into the system, to the conventional neural network. So I'm using the MobileNet classifier version, which is 5.0 current. Not right now, but we use it for the experiment. So we are using a transfer learning algorithm to retrain the network. And so we tried a different kind of mobile net versions. So first we tried the mobile net version 0.50, so which have which we find out that which have only less confidence level, and also we increase the training step using that current model, and it also come up it is also end up with an less confidence level of the system. So what we done is we are going to we change the mobile net versions first, and we use a mobile net version 1.0, so which will have a tremendous accuracy level, and at the same time it can recognize a vast amount of food items without an interruption. So I never say that this mobile net is the best classifier out there. There is also a classifier which is called which is Google's own Inception V3. So Inception V3 have a better way of recognizing a food item, and I'm doing with the food item. That's why I'm saying it as a food. So it can recognize an item and can tell you with a tremendous accuracy level, which will be around 85 or 19 above, something like that. But we can't able to take that model for a smaller storage devices like a smartphone, because the model will model after the training, the model will be around more than 18 MB. So we can't use that model, and we can't actually optimize that model, and we can't come up with that model for a smartphone devices, because the storage space required much more. So that's why we currently using that mobile net version 1.0, and we use that mobile net version, and we retrain the network doing putting a lot of kind of different kind of iterations, and finally we got a trained model, and we after that the retrained model from the TensorFlow model which can be converted for the Android application. So what we are doing is, we first of all we need to convert the
particular model which is already trained, we need to convert it as a light for that particular app that we are doing. So the TensorFlow light, so we need to convert it using the light converter, which is a feature of a TensorFlow. So we can easily convert that by putting a few lines of code, and we can make that model and optimize that model for that Android app. So once we done this, we need to put that app on and we need to put that model on an Android app, and we need to code according to that using the Java API and C++ API and interpreter, and also the Android neural networks. So which will actually tell you that how to use a system and how to make it more make an efficient app like that. This is a use case diagram, which first of all, we need to open the application and the authentication mode, which currently I'm using a Firebase for our TP generation. We need to give the number, and it will tell you a one-time password. And you need to, the admin use is mainly, which is like creating the app, creating the recipes and feed the app. So it will show the cooked food to the particular user, and they can read the recipes according to that. So the sequence diagram, which is there is a user and admin. The authentication are through the phone number, and the authentication through the OTP, which will be received by the user's phone, and that also the admin can update the recipes kind of features. Activity diagram. Which have as I told you earlier, the authentication through the phone number. It will check whether the user is valid or not through the OTP password that we generated, and it will show the food items. Once we show the food data, the user need to show the food items to the particular camera. If it's recognized, it will show the recipes according to that. If not, the user need to do it again. Modular description. The modules are mainly consist of four, which is start with the registration page and OTP generation page and image capturing page, and at the end the recipe identification page. The registration page is mainly all the authentication modules, which describes the interface between the user and the system. The user need to give the phone number of the particular user, and it will generate an for logging. And the OTP generation page will generate an OTP according to that, and it is sent to the user mobile phone. And the image capture, and after that it will show a home page, and there we can see an open camera icon. Then we can click that, then we can capture the images over there, and it will tell you the name of the particular images, the particular item, and it will show you the recipes according to that. And the generated recipe will be displayed on the recipe identification page. So these are the screenshots, which contains the splash screen, registration page, and OTP generation page. Then the home screen consists of one open camera button, and once we click the button, it will go into that camera mode, which will detect the images, and it will tell you as a food. Then at the end it will show you the recipe and that how to cook that particular item. The future enhancement is currently we done a system by using a computer vision and artificial intelligence system. So we are focusing on to improving the confidence level of the systems. Currently, we can't say that our system have a 100% accuracy. It can have a 80% of accuracy. So we need to improve the accuracy level that we are currently. That's a future enhancement. And to building an open visual assistant as a cook buddy. So currently it can recognize a food items through that normal camera application, but we cannot give you the instructions to the people that how to cook a food item, or if any doubt came, the user cannot ask to the app that what is this or like something. So we are focusing on to build an open visual assistant as a cook buddy. And also we are focusing on to implementing an auto learning algorithm with the help of a transfer learning. to learn the food items over the internet. So which means we cannot, we don't need to teach the system that the food items is like this, or we don't need to label the data and to tell the system. And at the end, to find the trending recipes based on the current location and showing them first while searching.
So while we are searching for a recipe, we are using a current location in Apple. So which means it will tell you what kind of food items which are trending right now in a particular location, and it will give you the recipes according to that. So these are our future Hangouts friends which we are currently focusing on. And the conclusion, which means we actually find out by using that computer vision and artificial intelligence that we can train a model within a few time, within a less amount of time with some spectacular confidence level. So in here, the project is an efficient methodology for recognizing a multiple food items with the help of a transfer learning with the conventional neural network. So it will find out the solution for those people who are struggling in cooking food, and also it will find helpful for those people who are running out of time in their day-to-day life, for them to think about an idea of making a meals made easy. Not only that, we find out that while using the transfer learning techniques, we are able to train a model among less time with some spectacular confidence level. So these kind of things which we mainly focused on, and we completed we also know that we also implement
the model for that particular mobile phone, which is like an Android application,
and it is giving some tremendous accuracy level in some kind of times. We cannot say that it is 100% accurate, but in sometimes it can show you a better accurate level or result. And it is also not only that, it will solve the problem like a lesser storage phone. Like an Android devices can have a computer vision, something like that. So this is a book. These are the book that we are referred for our final year project, Machine Learning for Hackers, written by Drew Carney and John Miles White, International Edition of 2018, and the Java for Beginners, and the Element of Statistical Learning, written Statistical Learnings. And something like that, and also the Java Core volume, and these are the web references: stackoverflow.com, www.tensorflow.org, and the Core Labs, and EDU Birdy, developers.android.com, and also the tutorial points of Java. And thank you. So currently we are going to start the demo of our app, which is called CookBuddy. So just click that get started link. So once we need to send an OTP for verification, which is like a registration page. So I'm going to give my particular phone number. Need to submit that particular phone number, so it will receive an 6-digit OTP from Google. So already we got the OTP password over there, so it will all automatically take that OTP and it will come into that home screen. So first of all, we need to show food items once we open the camera. So what we are going is I'm going to take in normal images which is stored already on my computer.
This is a home page. Here you can see an open camera button. So you just need to do is just open, just click on the button and show and food items as an image or like something. You just need to open the button now. So I click the button now.
displaying masala dosa accurately. Then when I turn it over, it's showing that they are plain dosa. So when I am turning back, supposed to come masala dosa. See, the difference is accurately showing over here. So it's a tomato rice, and it's coming as a tomato rice, and it's a curd rice. Actually, it's taking a bit time to switch over one food to another food, but it's showing accurate results right now. See, it's showing as a curd rice. So what we need to do is, if you want to know how to cook this food item, you just need to click on that curd rice button. So it's going to display the recipe of that particular food items. So we can throw it down and we can use it for cooking that particular item. So this is it. Thank you.